Good afternoon, folks. Now I'm going to start quiz number two. This is another review. So question number one, which of the following is a proprietary operating system for desktop and laptop computers? And the answer is Windows, right? Remember to be careful when you're choosing your choices that it says a proprietary, right? Which means that it's licensed and you are only using it, but you don't actually own it. You have a license to operate it on that machine and that machine only, and it says for desktop and laptop computers. So Linux is open source, and Android would work on the mobile devices and some tablets, and iOS works on iPhones and iMacs, but they're not desktops and laptops. So be careful you read the question completely, right? Question number two. Which of the following is not a type of user interface? And the answer here is application, programming interface, the API, right? So the rest of these are types: command-driven, menu-driven, and GUI, which is the graphical user interface, which is what I'm using right now, right? And then we have here question three. Each device attached to your computer has a special program called a blank that enables the device and the operating system to communicate with each other, and that is the device driver, right? So the every device that you have comes with a device driver, either already preloaded into your operating system, or it comes with the device, or you can go to the manufacturer's website to download it. Question number four, which of the following is the first step in the boot process? And the first process in the boot process here, according to our feedback, says that the BIOS is activated by turning on the computer, and that's the basic input-output system, right? So basically, that's when your computer boots up. It checks to see if you have a monitor, it checks to see if you have a keyboard attached, and then the BIOS will keep the date for the computer, and if for some reason, like your BIOS, your CMOS battery is bad, then it will go back to the initial day that your computer system board was manufactured. So that's what happens. And if you have any problems along the way, then your computer would either not boot up or you may not have a picture, right? Question five, the BIOS is stored on a blank chip, and that is a ROM chip, right? That's read-only memory. It's not something that you that will lose it when you power it off. So even if you unplug your computer and take out the CMOS battery, your ROM is not affected with your BIOS. It's still there, and it knows that it's a computer. It knows where the hard drive is. It knows certain things that will not be erased, right? That's burnt into the chip on the motherboard. Question number six, which of the following Windows utility programs arrange pieces of a file on your hard drive to allow it for faster access? And that is going to be defragment and optimizes drives. That's where your computer basically, when you defragment your drive, it puts files that have become fragmented back together, so they'll open more quickly, right? Which of the following is not a Windows utility program? And the answer here would be desktop cleanup. That if you get a desktop cleanup program, that's typically not something that's going to be included with Windows. But disk cleanup, defragment, and optimized drives, and system restores are all part of the operating system. And remember, you can be using the operating system when you're taking your quizzes, so you can go in and verify these things as well. Question number eight, Android is an open source operating system for network servers. The answer is false. Number nine, when your computer runs out of RAM, an operating system will borrow space from the CPU. The answer is false. It'll borrow space from the hard drive, and it creates what's called a paging file. Question number 10, installing a device driver can sometimes cause system instability. That is true. So typically, when you're a computer repair person and you want to know why someone's computer is giving trouble, you will ask them the first question: did you recently install a new piece of hardware or some software on this computer? So hardware will be one where if you have a corrupt device driver, or if it was installed incorrectly, or maybe that device is not compatible with your system, that can cause a problem, right? So that answer is true. Number 11, a blank is the set of instructions that a computer uses to accomplish a task. Select one. And here the answer is a program, right? So program is basically, remember you have two different types of software. You have operating system, and then you have applications or program software, which are designed to do specific things. Number 12, you have computers use a blank language consisting of zeros and ones, and that answer is binary. Binary basically is bias for two, and so binary is a zero of zeros, is a series of zeros and ones that are combined to basically be read by the computer and by the system board and the processor to perform calculations. All right, we have the blank of the operating system enables users to communicate with a computer system. The blank, the network adapter card allows users to communicate with the computer system. All right, I'm sorry, no, that's your user interface. I'm sorry. Yeah, the way it's written here is the way these questions come up. So the answer is user interface. So that allows you to communicate with the system. So an example of that would be if you have a voice activated system, if you're going to use a mouse, if you're going to use a keypad, keyboard or a stylus, that would be your user interface. That was D. Okay. 14. This one here, Mac OS is the operating system developed by, that is by Apple. 15. Which of the following two operating systems are most frequently used on tablets? And that's going to be Android and iOS. Those are designed for more portability. People like their iPads. They're very popular over the Windows, even though Windows has been gaining some ground into that market. And then Android, they were very predominant in a lot of the other devices that are out there that are not made by Apple. Most of those are made by our Android. Most of them have Android operating system on it. Apple's Mac OS in Windows are examples of, and those would be examples of operating systems. That is correct. And then number 17, a GUI, GUI is typically includes all the following except for, and the answer would be hardware, because there's no, that doesn't compatible, right? So basically your pointer is an example, the icons are an example, and a desktop would be the example, because those are, we used to call it eye candy in the business. You have it look pretty on your desktop, right? So it's underneath all of that, you have what's called a command line interface, which is just basically text, MS-DOS. Number 18, you can use your system restore to use your system settings to put it back to a specific date when everything was working properly, and the answer is true. You can do that. You should always have a set a restore date whenever you do a tune-up to your computer to make sure that you have the latest and the best operation that your system is capable of when you do that. And 19, cache memory is a form of ROM, read-only memory, and that answer is false, right? The operating system controls how your computer functions, and that is basically true, right? So this is how your system will interact and how you will work with it. So that is basically the control of your device, right? How that hardware interacts with you is determined by that operating system. Thank you very much. I'll see you back here for quiz number 3.